So here we have a counter example. Before hooks were introduced, this is normally the way that you use mobx with React. You create a class component and decorate it with the observer. Inside this class, you can directly access the state observables or the actions. And here we have our mobx store defined like this. It's an ES6 class, and in the end, we need to initiate and export it as an object. Now let's refactor it into using hooks. We start with importing observer from mobx-react-lite. And here you can see observer no longer works with classes, so it's time that we refactor it into stateless functional component. And here you go. The buttons are no longer working because our counter is no longer notified by mobx upon state changes. In order to fix this, we need to head back to our store component and actually wrap this store inside a React context. And here we go. The next step is to actually use the useContext hook from React to pull out this store object. The final step is to wrap this entire functional component inside the observer. And here we go. The app is working again. And this is how you refactor a class component decorated by mobx observer into a functional component using hooks.